see several modes of shaking. You could see the wave going up the building and being reflected on the roof, coming back down. With this multidirectional excitation of the shake table, we can be much more realistic in reproducing real earthquake ground motions. There are more than 800 sensors deployed on the specimen. With this data, the researchers are able to develop, calibrate, and validate the computational model that engineers in the real world use to design buildings and bridges and so on.
What we did today is we actually run two consecutive large earthquakes at the desired subsidence level through the building, then they observe the behavior, and what we can tell so far from afar is that building meet its design expectations, that there's no damage, there's no residual drift. I think it's pretty fun to see a big building shake and death back and forth.